Sadly, what many of these families came to find is that they had not really escaped Jim Crow at all, but found themselves in a new system of racial control, a new Jim Crow. Racially discriminatory laws across America ensured that poor people of color migrating from the South would be confined to certain parts of the city that we now think of as ghettos.
Very few people know this, but if you go back and you look at how African-American housing patterns were established in the 30s and 40s, even as a result of the New Deal, the FHA, which was a Democratic New Deal program to inspire home ownership in the midst of the Depression, did more to create ghettos than any other federal program before or since. Why? Because when they were creating the culture of home ownership in America, they were exclusionary to black people. They put them in the areas that were maybe a little bit economically depressed and subject to heavy rentership. And then they redlined those areas and they would not write FHA mortgages in those neighborhoods. Once those areas were redlined, that was basically a design for a ghetto.
In 1950, people in these neighborhoods were poor, but they had jobs. By 1960, we're talking about the jobless poor because industries had moved out of the inner city, leaving behind concentrated populations of poor people, vulnerable to drug trafficking and all of the other problems associated with joblessness.
And what happens when groups are denied access to the core economic engines in a society? They create their own out of prohibited economies. That was true of the Italians and the Irish and the Jews and everybody else who came to the cities a generation before African Americans arrived.